A somber vigil for the 157 victims of the Ethiopian Airlines crash today at Nathan Phillips Square. Dozens of people gathered here to honor the victims. 18 of them were Canadian, and many say this tragedy just hit too close to home. The pain still raw. Tears are shed as families have yet to come to terms with a devastating tragedy.
It's just too bad that she touched so many lives across Canada and also like in the world. And that's really like too young for her to be like that. But we had to move on because she write a lot in the blog that we have to move on.
It has been 2 weeks since Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302 crashed just 6 minutes after taking off. All 157 aboard were killed instantly.
We are crying over since that accident happened.
24-year-old Danielle Moore was one of the 18 Canadian victims remembered here today. She was traveling to Nairobi to attend the UN Environment Assembly, a passionate social advocate who wanted to make the world a better place, her family calling her an inspiration.
She only stayed here for a moment, but we promised, and of course the rest of the community will also follow the legacy of what she has left and who has fight for.
We all have sorrows.
The vigil bringing together people from across the city and even students from as far away as Ottawa, here to honor Carleton University professor Pius Adesanmi.
For Carleton, they lost an amazing professor. He was such a great man. So for me, I cried because I knew that the students there have been robbed of a great man, of a great teacher.
The incident sparking countries around the world, including Canada and the U.S., to ground the Boeing 737 MAX 8 aircraft. Just 5 months earlier, the same model was involved in another similar crash. An Indonesia Lion Air plane plunged into the ocean shortly after takeoff, killing 189 people. Boeing is now under the microscope for possible negligence in training pilots when the new aircraft was deployed. The crash took the lives of people from 35 countries around the world. An investigation is still underway to determine the exact cause. For City News, I'm Tina Yazdani.